एब्सोल्यूट एरर, रिलेटिव एरर एंड परसेंटेज एरर। सो हियर एब्सोल्यूट एरर इज द न्यूमेरिकल डिफरेंस बिटवीन द ट्रू वैल्यू ऑफ ए क्वांटिटी एंड इट्स अप्रॉक्सीमेट वैल्यू एंड इट्स अप्रॉक्सीमेट वैल्यू हियर दिस इफ कैपिटल एक्स आई टेक कैपिटल एक्स इज द ट्रू वैल्यू कैपिटल एक्स इज द ट्रू वैल्यू ऑफ ए क्वांटिटी एंड आई विल टेक एक्स वन इज इट्स अप्रॉक्सीमेट वैल्यू कमा देन द एब्सोल्यूट एरर दे विल डिफाइंड ई सफिक्स ए ओके एब्सोल्यूट एरर इज गिवन बाय हियर ea equals x minus x1 so we called this one as delta x now the relative error will define this one as er is defined by here er equals ea divided by capital X. So what is ea? ea is delta X divided by capital X. You have to remember this formulas. And next one, what is get? Percentage error and percentage error, that means we call it as EP, is defined by here EP equals 100 into ER, 100 into relative error, ER and delta X divided by X, that one also. So here we'll take the problem. So first one, an approximate value of pi. Pi is given by is given by x1 equals 22 by 7, that is 3.1428571, and its true value, and its true value, true value is capital X equals 3.1415926. Full stop. Find the absolute error and relative error. Now solution. So we have here what is absolute error formula? Absolute error, that means E of A is given by E of A equals capital X minus X1. So what is capital X they given? Here capital X they given 3.1415926 minus, what do you get? 3.1428571. Okay, so if you difference, what do you get here? Difference is minus 0.0012645. So this is your absolute error. Now here what do you get? Relative error. So here relative error, that is E of R, is given by here ER equals EA divided by capital X. So what is EA? It is minus 0.0012645 whole divided by capital X. What is capital X here? 3.1415926. So if you divide, we get minus 0.000402. So this is the required solution. Now here I will take another problem. Find the value of S equals A square root B divided by C cube. So where A equals 6.54 plus or minus 0.01, B equals 48.64 plus or minus 0.02, and C equals 13.5 plus or minus 0.03. Also find the relative error. So solution. So here we have S equals, what is the given? A square root B divided by c cube. So where, what are the a values they given? A is equal to 6.54 plus or minus 0.01. B equals 48.64 plus or minus 0.02. C is equal to 13.5 plus or minus 0.03. So forget about here these error values. So only you have to take 6.54. So what you get for a square, it is you get 42.7716. And here root b, so what you get root b, only you have to take 48.64. so how much you get? You'll get 6.9742 you'll get. And for c cube, only you have to take for this one. Okay, so you have to forget about the errors. So here how much you get for c cube means it is 2460.375. now put for this one, so s is equal to what you get, 42.7716 into 6.9742 whole divided by 2460.375. so we'll get the answer is 0.121 something. Okay, so I'll take 0.121. now you have to find out, hence you have to find out the relative error. So what do you get? S is equal to a square root b. Also here I have to find out the relative divided by c cube. So taking log on both sides. So what you get? Log s is equal to, here this becomes log a square, log a square root b minus log c cube, right? This can be written as afterwards. Yeah, afterwards we'll get here log s is equal to log s square plus log root b minus log c cube will get. So this can be written as, here this can be written as 2 times of log a plus here 1 by 2 times of log b minus 3 times of log c you will get. So here I will apply both side on capital delta. So log s equals 2 times of delta log a plus 1 by 2 times of delta log b minus, here this becomes plus because we will take relative error always maximum. So 3 times of delta log c. So this becomes what you get, delta s by s equals here 2 times of delta a divided by a plus 1 by 2 into delta b divided by b plus 3 into delta c divided by c. Now here we have to take delta a. So delta a means, here look at here, they given, we neglecting here a value, in a value neglecting 0.01, right? So that is your a, plus or minus always will taking positive. So what I get here, 2 times of delta a is 0.01 whole divided by, what is a value? It is 6.54 plus 1 by 2 times of delta b is 0.02 whole divided by b value is 48.64 and plus 3 times of delta C is 0.02 divided by C value is, sorry, 3 this is, C value is 13.5. So we'll get the value is 0.009931. So this is the required solution. So better you write here mod. If you get confusion, you can write mod for this one. Always you're taking positive. So next problem. Three approximate values of the number 1/3 are given as 0.30 and here 0.33 and here 0.34, which of these three values is the best approximate value? Approximation solution. So here we have delta. Here I'll take delta mod 1/3 minus 0.30. First element here 0.30. I'm taking positive value. So what I get here, if you take it LCM, so 1 minus 0.9 you'll get. So you'll get this can be written as 0.1 divided by 3. So this can be written as 1/30. So here in calci, 1 divided by 30. So how much you get? 0.0333. Right? So remember that one. And second one, 1 divided by 3 minus 0.033. So how much you'll get? This becomes here. If you take it 3 LCM, this becomes 0.01 divided by 3. So this can be written as 1 by 300. And another one. So here what you get? Mod 1/3 minus 0.34. Another value is 0.34. So if you divide this one, what do you get? If you take it 3 LCM and if you subtract this one, what do you get? 0.02 divided by 3. So this can be written as 150. Right? So here 1 divided by 150. So it is 0.66 something you'll get, right? So what do you get? 1 divided by 3. So for you to compare with 1 divided by 3. So if you divide by 1/3, you get 0.3333 recurring. So which one is near to? Which value is near for 1/3 approximate value? So it is 0.03 you will get. So here if you done 1 divided by 300, so it is recurring 0.333, so on, and here it is 0.6, so on you'll get. So this is the nearest value, that means 0.33. so therefore it follows that 0.33 is the best approximation फॉर वन बाई थ्री।